you hid behind a mask so long that you are left wondering, who am I really? Who am I really? That's what I wanted to know. You see, I encountered a great disappointment. I had been praying specifically for something. My heart leaped with joy when I thought this could be my moment. Then I discovered otherwise. I was left feeling empty and broken. Devastation filled my heart, but devastation soon led to great depression. This is when my masquerade began. It seemed that I had developed a mask for all occasions. I needed the mask to hide what my heart was really feeling. I kept thinking, I'm leaving pastor's wife. What would people think if they knew the depression that filled my life? I just couldn't let anyone know. So before leaving home, I would slap on my Sunday mask and pretend that I had it all together. Or I would slap on my work mask and pretend that I was a good Christian without a care in the world. My mask worked temporarily. I think for a while I had my friends fooled. No one knew that inside my heart was breaking or that my free time was filled with tears. My fake smile and phony laughter temporarily hid the emptiness I felt. Still, the mask began to hinder relationships. One by one, friendships began to dissolve. Each time, I would just grab another mask to hide behind, growing more and more depressed. On the inside, I was crying out for help, but on the outside, too scared to lay the mask down and just tell someone. I was becoming weary hiding behind the mask. There were days that instead of picking up the mask, I just stayed in bed and pulled the covers over my head, wishing I could avoid the world forever. Hiding behind the mask was slowly wrecking my life. I found that I couldn't be honest with myself, others, or even God for that matter. It was the day that I contemplated ending life that I realized that I needed to lay the mask aside and find help. I needed God to unveil my heart completely. I needed to begin to see the real me as God's me. I began to remove the limits I had placed on God. I began to allow Him to heal what was hurting and to fix what was broken. I discovered that only when I remove the mask and see myself in the light of God's perspective am I able to be the person God created me to be, the real me. We often put on masks to hide ourselves from the world. It's scary to let people know what we're really feeling, to let them see who we truly are. We ask, should I be honest? Should I place myself in a vulnerable position? What if I get hurt? Being sincere, honest, and open is frightening. 1 Samuel 16:7, for God sees not as man sees. For man looks on the outward, but the Lord looks at the heart. We see our imperfections, our frailties, our faults, and our flaws. But God sees our heart. He sees our purpose, and He sees our destiny. Once we are unveiled and stripped of everything we were trying to hide behind, God can then operate in us and through us. Real living begins when we put play hide and seek with God and others and respond to the generous invitation to come close to me. We must remove our mask to hear these words, you are forgiven, come close to me. Jesus invites us to exchange our mask of deception for His garment of perfection. That's when we become the real me that Jesus sees.
Amen.
Foolish heart, looks like we're here again. Same old game of plastic smile. But you see,